This is Tom Blair with Inside Colorado Wrestling, doing another episode of Boundary to Boundary, Colorado High School Head Coaches. Our guest today is the new head coach at Chatfield High School, Joe Moore. How's it going, Joe?
I'm doing good. I'm doing good. Middle of the summer here and getting ready to leave for Fargo this Wednesday, so I'm excited for that. And yeah, everything's good.
How many kids do you have going to Fargo?
We've got two girls, Janessa George and Taylor Meese, and as far as from our Chatfield Wrestling Club, we've got four boys. So we've got Kai Saito, Brody Moret, Corbin, I may butcher this last name, but Purdom, and then I'm definitely going to butcher this name, but Johnny, who's from Azerbaijan, but eligible age-wise, so.
Okay. This is our second interview with you, because last year, or a year and a half ago, we interviewed you as the head coach at Littleton High School. So this is a current change. So what made you make the switch?
Yeah, I figured that question was coming.
Well, we'll get that one out of the way.
Yeah. It goes without saying, it was an extremely difficult decision. I, no pun intended, wrestled with it for a really long time. Wrestled with it very deeply. I shouldn't say a long time. It was about a month's worth of, having practiced here in the fall because of COVID reasons, and getting to, I already knew Mike George, but that relationship growing. And then finally kind of just all the pieces coming together as the high school season's wrapped up last March. So what is the reason for moving? Obviously, I've been working with Mike at the club. The club that is here and naturally feeds into the surrounding schools is extremely valuable and strong. And it goes without saying that that's an integral part of having success in the state of Colorado. But more than that, I'm not all about the trophy. So I can't whittle it down to just that. It was also the ability to impact kids from the club, and then the numbers that Chatfield usually garners over the numbers we were acquiring the last 5 years over Littleton. We'd grown that number, but it was still a number that kind of paled in comparison to what the general participation level is. And at the end of the day, I'm about impacting as many young people as possible, and so I just felt I had a better opportunity to do that at Chatfield. So that may be a long-winded answer, but hopefully that.
And also, you inherited the girls' team also?
Yeah, so at the moment, we're kind of working through exactly how the organization structure is exactly going to work. But we've decided that kind of the best approach is having one kind of CEO of the entire wrestling community. So that will make me the boys' head coach, and then also kind of just the director of wrestling in general at Chatfield. Still led as the head coach by Sandra George, because I can't be two places at once, obviously, if there's a girls' tournament and a boys' tournament.
You can't split yourself in half?
I can't. So, if there's a boys' tournament and a girls' tournament the same Saturday and they're not at the same place, I'll be with the boys, Sandra will be with the girls. But yeah, I am going to be I'm going to be directing the girls pretty extensively in terms of their practice schedule and their training regimen. So
now, is Chatfield Girls Club or team just Chatfield girls, or are they from a district?
As far as the high school?
Yes.
Not having fully gotten my hands into the program, I don't know if I can answer that with immunity and without error, but I'm pretty sure, given the fact that the girls sanctioned wrestling has not spread to every school, there are other schools from within the district that feed, give girls the choice of where they want to go to school or where they want to compete for wrestling at this time. So,
Okay.
I believe that's the right answer.
Now you've stated why you came over. How did it come about that you got the head position?
Yeah, so, like I said, last year was a really weird year with COVID. I think every single one of us had been kind of put into a position where we didn't have access to our rooms. And for a while there, we, by district policy, at least at Littleton, I didn't even have in-person contact with the athletes. When the in-person contact, assumed, there was still barriers to practicing at the school. And so that's where, having previously known Mike George, I said, hey, do you mind if I bring a couple of Littleton wrestlers over to Chatfield? Which is probably, it's funny to say that, because anyone who's listening to this is going to be like, oh, well, we should have never gone over there. But we got to build a relationship. Funny enough, Mike and I had always kind of, I'd always been trying to pull him. We're not that far away. Littleton and Chatfield are maybe a 10-minute drive from one another.
Right.
And I'd always been trying to kind of pull him over to establish a club at Littleton. And he'd always been trying to kind of, broker and massage me into the head coaching position at Chatfield. And both of us are pretty loyal, so neither one was moving. And, I'd finally been kind of chewing on it for a while and realized the resources that were available here and the support and, all the great coaching that already existed here at Chatfield Club and then Chatfield High School. And I was like, it's easier to go where it's already created than try and go recreate it at Littleton. So that was kind of one of the tipping points for me where I was finally open to the conversation. So,
okay.
So I hopefully that answers the question, but that's kind of how it came about. Once, like I said, Mike had always kind of said that, and all kudos to Paul Pernard, who was the previous head coach at Chatfield, and he's still going to be integrally involved and going to be an assistant coach. And but I think that the Chatfield organization, with Paul's admission, knew that it was, he loved coaching, but it wasn't necessarily something he could give himself to year round, which is something I'm able to do. Not married, no kids, and self-employed at this point in my life. So, got a lot of flexibility.
You have plenty of kids. It's called the wrestling club,
correct.
Wrestling team.
Yeah, I've got a lot of 16 to 18 year olds.
And traveling team, because you traveled quite a bit last year with Team Vision Quest.
Yep. Yeah. Shout out to Tom Blair on the other side of the camera there.
Yeah,
we did a lot of. I think I counted, and we did five tournaments out of state, Team Vision Quest, at least ones that I was along for. So
well, we did a total of eight.
Total of eight, and I think I was there for five. So
yeah,
it's pretty good numbers. And that's obviously a tremendous. Just like I talk about this resource, having traveling teams like that are a tremendous resource to wrestlers in Colorado. So.
So what are your goals and expectation for Chatfield High School, and what is your involvement, on the second question, with the Chatfield youth program or club?
Yeah, so I'll start abstract and then I'll whittle it down to the easy answer. But my abstract answer is to grow and promote the sport of wrestling in the state of Colorado. That's my goal, regardless of where I'm at, grow and promote the sport of wrestling. It's changed my life in a lot of positive ways. I know a ton of other people that it's had a positive impact on. It's a great sport. So that's kind of my abstract answer, is to grow and promote the sport of wrestling, increase those numbers on the boys team for Chatfield, and continue the tradition that's starting to build on the girls side of things, and make sure that tradition is never tarnished, and that it's built around great culture and being great people. You can win all the state championships in the world, but if people it's one thing if people hate you because you're a winner, it's another thing if people hate you because you're not a good person. So making sure we have excellent culture established there. But then, like I said, going from the abstract down to the finite and maybe a little bit more of the straightforward is, I want to see our team win a state championship. I want to crown individual state champions. I want to see those individuals go on and be successful in college. And I'd love to see even, you know, a handful of those go on and compete internationally. When I was younger, it's no one's fault, but it wasn't necessarily heavily promoted or advertised that, you know, everyone can have the dream of being an Olympic champion. I'm not saying that's not the reason it didn't happen for me or for others, you know, but I don't ever want anybody to someday say, well, you know, I wasn't an Olympic champion just because someone didn't, you know, project the dream for me. So I want to see that come out of Colorado. And this is going to be a quick shout out to my old school Littleton, but DM Hallett, who was a junior senior in my first 2 years at Littleton, is at the Northern Michigan at the Greco Regional Training Center. There he was an All-American last year, and he's trying to make the senior national team, so it can be done.
Okay. Some of the people may not have watched or listened to the interview with you last couple years ago, so give them some of your wrestling background.
So I started wrestling when I was probably before I can remember or able to walk, when I was about 4 or 5 years old. My dad had me starting to go into our club back in the northwest corner of Iowa, Okoboji, Iowa.
What was the town?
Okoboji. It's a Native American name.
Okay.
Not sure what it stands for, even though I'm from there. So was part of that, you know, as a youth. I wrestled in high school there. I was a state place winner. Compiled 129 career wins as a high schooler. Went on and competed for the University of Iowa for 4 years. Was 125 and 133 pounder for them. So wrestled for the Hawkeyes. And then shortly after that, I did some youth coaching, kind of club coaching in the state of Iowa for a club, Ubasa. Ubasa trained out of Iowa City and then kind of the Des Moines, Ankeny area. And then I kind of took a little hiatus, and I moved out to Colorado, and about 2015-16, I took the head coaching job at Littleton. So I've been there the last 5 years. This will be my sixth year. This first year at Chatfield will be my sixth year as a head coach here in the state of Colorado. So,
okay, with the background in youth coaching and high school coaching, so what is your involvement going to be on the Chatfield youth program?
Oh, yeah, you asked that question.
You didn't answer it. Sorry, I thought I'd bring it up again.
Obviously, there, you know, with being the head high school coach, there's certain limitations I have to when I can be involved and to what degree I can be involved. But, you know, when the calendar year allows it and the rule book allows it, you know, I'll be here to be a coach for these individuals at the club and the youth. And, you know, regardless of where they go. I'm here, like I said, to grow and promote the sport of wrestling. I'm here to help all individuals, whether they end up at Chatfield or not. I want to see every, you know, like I said, at the end of the day, yeah, Chatfield's where I'm trying to win a state championship, or we're trying to win a state championship, and I'm leading that. But I want to see Colorado wrestling grow and thrive. And so, I'll be helping when I can and when the calendar and the rule book allows it, so.
Okay, moving back up to the high school level, what do you have for returning kids in the program, boys and girls? And I understand it, COVID affected a lot of the kids that came out last year. Mm-hmm. How are you gonna get those kids back into the program?
Yeah, so to the degree I've kind of, you know, I took the position pretty much in April. And so to the degree since then, I've been able to jump in and get my hands dirty and start working with some of the individuals. I can speak to those. I'm not gonna be able to speak to some of those individuals that are, you know, purely involved during the wrestling season because I haven't gotten that far yet. But from the girls' side, I know we've got strong returners in Janessa George, Taylor Meese, Kaylee, I think her last name's Irwin, sorry. We had...
You got to know these girls' names,
we,
you know.
We had Cameron Smith. Yeah, I know, I got to know the full names, right?
Right.
I'm good with, like, first names, but... we had Cameron Smith and Lauren Smith go to the University of Iowa camp, along with Savannah Briam. There was three strong representatives there. As far as the boys go, Brody Moretz, a returning state qualifier for us, We're going to have a very, very strong freshman class, probably 8 to 10 experienced wrestlers in the freshman class. Jay Applinap, potentially Sid Dillon. He's in the Conifer situation, and they're trying to figure out where they're going to go. But very strong freshman class. And as far as upperclassmen, Jackson, I'm not sure his last name, but Jackson I know is a returning upperclassman. So we're here to grow wrestling. You know, there's some names for you, but I think I said this in my last interview even, is that, you know, I give you a list of names, and the names we're going to be talking about in February next year are probably going to be completely different. So hopefully some of those are still involved, but I'm sure there'll be some names that I haven't mentioned. So.
Well, it sounds like you've got your hands full with a strong high school team on the boys' side and a super strong high school team on the girls' side that they won the state champ with the banner in the window. And also with the youth program that you're going to have your fingers in just a little. So good luck in the upcoming season in November, and have a great summer.
My hands are full, but there's still room. All right, so appreciate it, Tom. And yeah, we'll look forward to seeing everybody this coming wrestling season.